we got another small little project going on here now. This is a Rock-ola 443 100 selection jukebox. It's a small one, about as small as the carnival that's still buried right here. The last guy to have my amplifiers destroyed my amplifiers, so that goes $45 worth for one amplifier I bought. The other one that came with this is now destroyed, so I don't got anything anymore. But yeah, this one needs a little bit of care, but other than that, this thing does work. It does not select; the thing just keeps circling. I need to replace all the bulbs in it because they're all shot, and I'm gonna have to get some new starters. That's what it looks like for the cabinet. I wish out the back, and it's got one piece of board that's missing on there, so I'm gonna have to do something about that. I'll show you what the inside is. It's got this thing still in here. The record's not, but the sleeve is. It's like an 80s rock band. This is the inside of the jukebox. I'll get a little bit of a light here. I'll light things up. Right now I'm running this on a cord because I don't got a battery attached to my camera. But there's the jukebox. I got some records I just tossed in here because this thing didn't have any. It's been sitting in this one guy's garage I don't know how long, so. Amplifier still works, but it needs cleaning, of course. The volume control is staticky, and the thing doesn't work on left and right that well, so. Like I said, on mono and stereo don't work right now. Control center, and that works just fine. It's got a plug for a receiver, but don't got anything to receive with. I don't. My cat, anyway. It's got some rust here and there, you can see here. And it's got some on here. And the mechanism that has this play the flip side needs work, so I'm gonna have to get this carousel off, clean that cam that's down there. I'm gonna have to get this off. But the only way to get it off, so I'm gonna get this off. That bar. I have to get that off first to get it out of my way. That way I can get to the carousel. Since I can't make any selections, I have to trip everything manually. God damn it. There you go. Where are you going? This one. There's the coin thing that needs to be cleaned. Lubed up anyway. I'll put on the record if you guys watch it. It kind of loads right and kind of doesn't. It just depending on how this wheel sit. And the speed is wrong, so. You can see this thing actually picks up and rejects pretty quick. It's a quick little thing. I'm not too sure because if it's a 100 selection jukebox or what it is, But I know with my other ones, like the GP160 and the 447 console, both of those running a little bit slower for the transfer arm coming over for voltage-wise, but this one actually moves a whole lot quicker. So, like I said, I don't know if it's just me or the way this thing is. Yeah, but anyway, this is about 1970s for what I looked. It's got a different look than the ones I've seen, like this, for example. It's got the logo right on here. I think there is a light that goes underneath this thing, but I don't know how it's going to shine through this because it's like a reflecting mirror. But, let's see. I can actually get the door open for you, this bottom part. This might take me a second. I gotta flip one notch first, over here. And I gotta flip the other notch. This thing takes some pretty big bulbs, and like I said, I gotta replace the whole starter for this thing. Whoa, why did my camera just focus itself? Much like they bumped it, sorry. There's the motor of the unit. As you can see, there's quite a bit. It's got some pretty big speakers in here. It's got this box, which I don't know what it's for. I guess I'll find out later when I play with it more. There's a ballast. There's a starter for a light bulb. And the funny thing is, for this thing here, they got the sockets all messed up behind this panel. There's a bulb back there, but there's nothing in it right now, so. Because the bulb that was originally in here is bad, so. But this thing is definitely needs a lot of cleaning. It's got a lot of gunk. Like you can see on that motor, there's some gunk. There's some down there that you can clean off. I would try to get to the underneath the carousel, but it's too much of a pain because I have to remove this door first. But this right here would need to be cleaned out. You need to clean this motor that runs the gripper part here back and forth, as you see. That's where that runs. And the carousel motor's right there. That's that piece. You see, that's the cam. And I'll put this in manual. This thing does need clean, so before anything will work. So it's gonna need some work. And what I found out, for one thing, I hear. I need to get this light in a good enough spot here. All right, I got it in a kind of decent spot. But that piece right there, I have to work with this. So this is what flips it back and forth. Watch here. I'll select something here real quick here. All right, I just need to put this in a certain spot. All right. I'm going to put this on a flip side, so I need if I want to play the flip side, I'm going to have to push this thing manually, so. Let's put a little force on it. Let's just put a little force on it, and the thing would be able to play the flip sides. So, that's about how it works, so. The thing will go back as it's done, but it won't engage, so and that's why the cam's a little messed up in there. I need to get that cleaned out, so. But yeah. This one definitely needs a little bit of cleaning, but it needs less work than my other ones do. My other jukeboxes, so. But that is the Rock-ola Model 443. Thanks for watching.